Now, moving on to the next item on the agenda, I'd like to give a brief introduction of what we are trying to do. I know I've been saying it's a bit of a mystery since afternoon. The Skill India campaign was launched by our Honorable Prime Minister on 15 July 2015. This campaign aims to train over 40 crore people in India in different skills by 2022. The objective is to enable a large number of Indian youth to take up industry-relevant skills, training, and helping them secure a better livelihood. Today, the Skill India mission has seen success due to the active participation of all stakeholders. The objective of today's gathering is to validate the industries supporting this campaign in the form of a pledge and ensuring an enhanced synergy between industry needs and government policies. With this background, I'd like to request our chairman, Mr. Anil Kumar Muniswamy, to give a brief on the ESSCI effort between ISA and Electronic Skills Sector Council of India.
Good evening, friends. I don't take much time, but I must really use this platform to really highlight the work done by one great organization, which is based in Delhi, Electronic Sector Skill Council of India. In fact, I know that they have been working, at least in my knowledge, 2013 onwards. They have put great efforts in creating the content first and addressing the needs of the industry. See, today we all know that it's extremely difficult to get skilled manpower. Be it a, you know, simple technician for installing a TV to, you know, little high-end skills like embedded engineers, VLSI engineers, electronics design engineers, software engineers. It's extremely difficult nowadays because of growing demand and there's so much of competition in the market to grab this skilled manpower. One organization, that is Electronic Sector Skill Council of India, has been working very silently in creating this trained skill workforce. They have been working with ISA for more than 5 years, as per my knowledge, and they do a lot of work in universities like KLE Tech, Sandbox Foundation, and across the country in almost all the universities. They have a separate program called University Program. Then they actually provide a very tailor-made training program. One best example is, we are working with Welfare Department of Karnataka. They asked us to provide training for various classes of sections of people, especially more backward, those who come from villages. So we identified, you know, 3-4 programs for them. One is, you know, training people to how to install LCD TVs and then do the first level of servicing. Then how to install modems, CPE instrument, and then how to configure that. These are not normal skills. Slightly it requires some internet knowledge and all that. So we are just doing this tailor-made program, and the entire content is provided by Electronic Sector Skill Council of India, and that made our life so easy. So we want to make this organization even more popular, so we have decided that, first of all, for whom this kind of trained people is required. It is actually required for the industry. So industry should come forward and pledge, you know, their pledge with Electronic Sector Skill Council of India, saying that I am ready to take people from your organization. So we thought that using this great opportunity of Spacetronics and Deftronics, and also to create awareness, we thought that let us invite some companies who can come and say that, yes, I am ready to work with Electronic Sector Skill Council of India, and I am going to give my requirements. This is what I need. It could be embedded engineer, VLSI, or hardware engineer, C++, whatever it is. You can always tell them, and then they will provide you know, candidates on a regular basis. And this is going to be at very, very economical price compared to, you know, candidates you hire from very expensive consultancy firms. So I request Mr. Mohapatra, CEO of ESSCI, to come here and you know, talk about his program, and then he's going to invite all the companies who are going to do this pledging today. And I think that is the beginning, actually, I would say that. ESSCI and industry collaboration. Mr. Mohapatra, please.
I thank ISA for giving us this opportunity, and particularly for this session, which involves acknowledgement of ISA members to ESSCI Skill India agenda. We are on this agenda for the last 5 years. As a government body, we provide an ESSCI framework-based ecosystem for outcome-based training, starting from national occupational standards to qualification packs, training center affiliation, assessor and trainer certification, up to setting up of industry-sponsored training center as well. In our journey, in the last 5 years, we have established 4,000 training centers across the country. We have done 159 qualification packs for training. We have 3,700 certified trainers across the country. We have 1,800 certified assessors across the country. And we have trained more than 8 lakhs people as a beneficiary across 444 districts and 28 states. So we have become pretty big in our journey so far with respect to the Skill India campaign. And we continue to move. And with the recent announcement of government to get into Apprenticeship Acts and RPL 4.0, we encourage industry to participate with us. And I'm very thankful to all the industry members who are willing to sign an acknowledgement with us that we can continuously work with you. And we assure you, we will give you commitment to give you the right people as per your requirement for today or on your future requirements. And we are quite willing to work on flexible requirements, new requirements. In fact, I find whenever a customer demands something, it is more genuine. So we accept it. We are not rigid like a government framework. We are pretty flexible, and we are ready to participate with the industry for any new requirements which doesn't exist with us, but they perceive the market probably needs them for future. And we are seeing a lot of changes coming in the electronics, and we are seeing a lot of new job roles coming, and the training is not a static thing. It has to change. The basic purpose of us is how to make short-term training very agile and very industry-friendly and very time-based so that we don't lose time in delivering the people as with respect to what you need. Now, just I will invite the people who are with us. You will do that? Okay, thank you. Thanks, all of you. And I really appreciate ISA on this. And I assure all the ISA members who are with me on this, we'll be tracking you, we'll be following you, and we'll be having regular interactions with you. We will make sure that we will meet your requirements. Thank you.